So let's start again in the scripts folder. And there we have our freshly brewed publisher. And we also see there is a template subscriber script. So let's use that in our new sensor underscore info underscore subscriber dot py and start editing it. As always, we update the comment first. Then let's import the sensor information message type from the correct location this time. Okay. And then we also give a meaningful name to the topic callback function and write a relevant log message to print sensor data that we read from the topic. Like that. Then we rename the function appropriately and update the relevant portion of the comment and also give meaningful names to the node and the topic to subscribe to. Okay, and lastly, we update the function call in the main module and we are done. Also, learning from our past experience, we will already make the subscriber script executable before we run it. Awesome, we should now be able to run our new subscriber node. So we start ROS core and we run our new subscriber node with the ROS run command. And nothing again. Well, let's see if the topic we subscribe to is available. Oh, there it is. Huh? Still nothing on the terminal? Let's inspect the topic details then with the ROS topic info command. Aha, there we see it. No one is publishing the topic. So there is one more important lesson for us. For the ROS topic list command, it is sufficient to list a topic in its list as long as there is either a publisher or a subscriber to the topic. So the message here is to not jump to a conclusion only by looking at the ROS topic list output. Inspect the topic with the ROS topic info as well while trying to debug your ROS problems. So we know what to do now. Just start the ROS publisher node that publishes the sensor underscore info topic. And voila, there we have our distance sensor reading from our new subscriber. And with that, we conclude this module on ROS topics. In the next module, we will learn about ROS services. See you after a short break then.